Tonight, remembering Frank Sinatra.
This is the CBS Evening News. With Dan Rather reporting from CBS News headquarters in New York.
Good evening. We begin tonight with the death of an American original, Frank Sinatra. For the better part of this century, he set the standard for popular music in this country and around the world. For millions of fans, his voice was the soundtrack for a lifetime of memories.
Medical Center in Los Angeles. The cause, a massive heart attack.
He has been in poor health. I can't say failing health, but he's been in poor health for the last 2 to 3 years.
Sinatra's last TV appearance, a 1995 special saluting him on his 80th birthday. The producer of that show, a friend of Sinatra, talked about how the entertainer spent his final hours.
He was outside and he was kind of adorably grumpy. And he was his own sweet, you know, wonderful self.
Today, a man with a clarinet serenaded one of Sinatra's three stars on the Hollywood Boulevard Walk of Fame as other people brought flowers. The usually quiet street in front of Sinatra's Beverly Hills mansion became crowded with TV camera crews as friends and family members dropped by to pay their condolences. Singers Steve Lawrence and Edie Gourmet came and went before dawn. The fans showed up all day long and are still there.
If I didn't have a car, I would have walked here, or I would have hitchhiked here. I just have to be here.
He is survived by his wife, Barbara, and four children. The family says funeral services for the entertainer will be strictly private, with burial expected to take place in Palm Springs. George Lewis, NBC News, Beverly Hills.
We'll have more on Frank Sinatra later, but now...
Those of us who've read a lot about Sinatra over the years, those of us who've tried to study him, have found that Sinatra the man has always been pretty hard to get at, to say the least. Sinatra the public legend is who we know.
Won't you tell her, please, to put on some speed?
He came of age with the long-playing record. When he was a very young singer, his fans were so enamored of him, it's a wonder they ever heard him.
My name is Francis Albert.
Francis Albert Sinatra was born in Hoboken, New Jersey. His father, an Italian immigrant who wanted his son to be a prize fighter.
Until I hear you at the door.
Sinatra wanted to sing, like his idol, Bing Crosby. He was never a jazz singer per se, but it was with the big bands, namely Tommy Dorsey, that he first developed his tender style. By 1942, almost after the first night at the Paramount Theater in New York, he was a star.
I get no kick from champagne.
He was an idol to guys as well as girls, a real working class hero, and he loved the audience.
So tell me, why should it be true that I get a kick out of you?
But when the war ended, Sinatra's popularity faded. 10 years later, Sinatra the actor was begging for a part in From Here to Eternity. He would emerge as a major movie star. He won the Oscar that year.
The world on a string, sitting on a rainbow.
These were also the glory days of Sinatra singing, one album after another.
Let's take it nice and easy.
Living life his way without question. The Rat Pack, as he and his buddies were known, included Dean Martin and Sammy Davis Jr. They took the Las Vegas nightclub scene by storm.
But now the days are short.
The country has always been fascinated with Sinatra's personal life, adored by women, married four times, including to Ava Gardner and Mia Farrow, friend of presidents, Jack Kennedy especially, friend of the mafia. A Justice Department memo in 1962 linked him to 10 of the country's top hoodlums. Sinatra was proudly Italian. I wouldn't have so much trouble, he said, if my name didn't end in a vowel.
Start spreading the news. I'm leaving today.
The voice, as we knew him, old blue eyes, performed right into the 90s. Half the country has fallen in love with Sinatra's help. And when it didn't work out, there was always a Sinatra song to give the pain meaning.
Make it one for my baby, and one more for the road.
For a new generation, the Sinatra family has its own website. Today, there's just the name, Sinatra, and the date of his birth and his death. And Sinatra is singing softly in the background.
As I leave.
More Sinatra in a moment.
When somebody loves you, it's no good unless he loves you. All the way.
They breathe.
Each time I find myself.
They paid their respects at his birthplace. From Times Square to his parents' native Italy.
Le 7:50 ora italiana è morto a Los Angeles Frank Sinatra.
He was mourned today around the world.
I would say that Frank Sinatra is the Mozart of the pop music.
And like Mozart, Sinatra defined a style and time. On hearing of Sinatra's death, his good friend Nancy Reagan released a statement. We will miss our friend, she said, as will the world. Bill Whitaker, CBS News, Los Angeles.
As Jerry Bowen reported, Frank Sinatra did not like the press, and he rarely sat down for interviews or allowed camera crews behind the scenes. There was one notable exception. In 1965, Sinatra allowed CBS cameras, under the direction of now 60 Minutes man Don Hewitt, to follow him for a CBS News documentary and be questioned by Walter Cronkite. Later in this broadcast, we'll show you some of that special footage.
Solo albums, more top 40 albums than any other artist, and he appeared in almost 60 films. This was a life of remarkable achievement, but it was also filled with drama and scandal. But first and always, there was that voice.
The melody haunts my reverie.
He took lyrics and turned them into poetry. Frank Sinatra was quite simply the most important popular musician of the 20th century.
She'd never bother with people she'd hate. That's why the lady is a tramp.
The legend began in Hoboken, New Jersey. During a stint with a local singing group in 1939, he was discovered by trumpeter Harry James, who put him to work for $75 a month. In less than a year, Sinatra jumped to Tommy Dorsey's orchestra.
It's the last call for love.
But real stardom came in 1942 when he appeared solo at the Paramount in New York.
When we opened that morning, nobody knew what to expect. And they let out a yell, and I tell you, I thought the top of the roof would come off of the building.
He became popular music's first sex symbol, filling a need for women who missed their men in World War II. There were lucrative contracts. One concert brought $30,000 in a single week. Huge money. And there was Hollywood. But in 1952, Sinatra's career took a steep slide. His sound went out of style. Surprisingly, it was a performance as a dying GI in From Here to Eternity that earned him an Academy Award and marked his comeback. Later, he led the Rat Pack of Sammy Davis Jr., Peter Lawford, and Dean Martin. He stood for glamour and style and high living.
Deep in the heart of me.
But there was always that dark side as well. Sinatra was sued for punching a rider. He had too many mobster pals, too many girlfriends.
And there were four wives. The first, Nancy, who bore his three children. He left her for actress Ava Gardner, his great love. The marriage lasted just 11 months. Frank was 50 when he married a 20-year-old Mia Farrow for 2 years. Since 1976, his wife had been Barbara Marx.
Fairy tales can come.
come true.
Frank Sinatra was a bundle of contradictions, Mr. Charm, but the dark brooder. But always that voice.
It's witchcraft.
And by the time he was forgetting lyrics and needed a teleprompter, it was a little sad. But by then, the man, his music, the myths were part of our memories forever.
Without a song.
All over this country tonight, there are memories, personal and collective, of the chairman of the board, and NBC's Jim Avila has a look at how Frank Sinatra's fans are remembering him.
A people's tribute on the streets of Frank Sinatra's hometown, Hoboken, New Jersey.
He'd never bother.
Just sit on my bench and listen to Frank all day.
Across the Hudson from Manhattan, working class Hoboken knew Sinatra by his records, like the rest of his fans. Bartender Leo DeLizzi remembers the day Frank said goodbye, rarely crossing the Hudson again.
He says, "Leo, I don't think I'm going to see you no more." I said, "Why?" "I signed up with Tommy Dorsey's."
Sinatra was a big city guy. Home was the best hotel room in New York, Chicago, Miami, or Vegas. Anywhere where the bars stayed open late and the maitre d' held his table. From Patsy's on New York's West Side, where he got his favorite red sauce.
He touched you in many ways.
To the woman in Chicago's Little Italy who served him chicken Vesuvio, reliving her days as a bobby soxer.
I'm the girl that sat in the first row of the Chicago for four shows. I adore the man since 1939. It's been a long love affair.
At Jilly's Saloon in Chicago, Sinatra biographer Bill Zamy remembers it isn't just the voice fans loved, it's the style.
I mean, he's the little guy who made it. He's the guy, he's tough, he's tender, he's warm, he's ready to fight for what's right.
Chicago columnist Irv Kupcinet followed Sinatra since the 40s and knows his fighting side well.
Frank and I were very close friends until I wrote something he didn't like, of course. And then he picked up the phone and used a few expletives to tell me what he thought about me.
The summer wind.
Singer Jimmy Damon built his act around Sinatra songs. It's not a nostalgia act. Sinatra's work sounds fresh even to young ears.
It's the most beautiful experience I've ever seen as an entertainer, to have such a large mixture of young adults, adults, and senior citizens. And many of them are just dancing.
But not today. Today is for ballads, torch songs.
Till we meet again, Frank. Sing it again.
Jim Avila, NBC News, again, Chicago.
And again.
Up next, Sinatra's remarkable impact in this country, the voice, the influence, the style that crossed decades.
You are all I long for, all I worship and adore. In other words, please be true. In other words, I love you.
Just a year ago, when a hit movie called Swingers chronicled 20-somethings in Los Angeles still trying to emulate Frank's swagger and style. In today's parlance, Frank Sinatra lived large, and America loved it for the most part. More on that tonight from NBC's Bob Paul.
All he did was change American pop music and our culture. Five generations later, the swing and the sexiness he introduced live on.
If that isn't love, it will have to do.
The face was bony, the Adam's apple bobbed, but the voice was a jewel, and with it, he did what no one else had ever quite done.
He understood the lyrics. He often explained to me that you have to know what you're singing about.
Sinatra's voice, what one called the voice from the end of the bar, turned music into an aphrodisiac. Music to make love by, said writer Gay Talese, and much love had been made to it all over America.
He was our leader. He really was our leader. The guy was the best.
Bing Crosby was his original inspiration, but the impact of Frank Sinatra went far beyond that of a crooning balladeer.
Let's take it nice and easy. Was as profoundly developed as any musician on any instrument who ever lived.
The sound was creamy, pure, the technique superb, his timing flawless. But it wasn't just how it sounded, it was also how Sinatra did it, his way, all or nothing at all.
Coat that bar, lift that veil,
And in the process, Sinatra became what Talese called the embodiment of the emancipated male, the man who can do anything he wants, anything, because he has the money, the energy, and no apparent guilt.
Sinatra never took a defensive posture. He said, this is who I am, this is what I do, here is where I'm going, and stop me if you can.
With the talent, with the attitude, Sinatra became an icon, the first American-born heartthrob to make Americans shriek and wail a full decade before Elvis. His wardrobe set styles. His hard-drinking macho way set the tone for the celebrated Rat Pack. He aged, but mostly he endured, appealing for more than 50 years, spawning a host of imitators then and now, sharing the limelight, if not the talent, with younger artists. A lyric, he once said, can be a lament or a joy, and in his case, the sum and substance of a person's life.
It was a very good year.
Looking back, his friend Shirley MacLaine said that Sinatra helped us understand our lives more clearly, doing it with a voice magic for the wee small hours of the morning, magic anytime. Bob Fall, NBC News, Washington.
His music is almost aristocratic. It's a dichotomy in the middle of which we are all stuck. It's a delicious puzzle that a man as turbulent and as occasionally unattractive in behavior as Sinatra could make such beautiful, articulate, and honest music. I think it goes back to he sang with his guard down.
Jonathan Swartz, Sinatra may have sung with his guard down, but he rarely let it down otherwise to grant behind-the-scenes access or interviews to the press. This was one of the few times Sinatra did both in a CBS News broadcast in 1965. We want to take time now to share some of it with you again and enjoy.
And I've got you under my skin. I've got you deep in the heart of me. So deep in my heart that you're really a part of me. I've got you under my skin. Fill my heart with song. Let me sing forevermore. Because you are all I long for, all I worship and adore. You make me feel so young. You make me feel like spring has sprung. Every time I see you grin, I'm such a happy individual. Oh, yeah. When I was 35, it was a very good year.
Comes with a swinging year.
It was a very good year for blue-blooded girls of independent means. We'd ride in limousines.
Yeah.
You know.
The CBS News documentary those highlights were taken from will be broadcast in full next Thursday evening here on CBS. Fans of Frank Sinatra might want to remember something he once said about a broken heart. It takes a long time to heal, Frank said, but playing one of my albums can help. That's part of our world tonight.
My way. Yes, there were times I'm sure you knew.
bit off more than I could chew, but through it all, when there was doubt, I ate it up and spit it out. I faced it all and I stood tall and did it my way.
Good night, everyone.
More than I could chew.